Greetings everyone. Welcome to CMS News. Post-graduation classes begin. The college began its post-graduation classes for the first-year students with a two-day induction program earlier this month. The program was conducted via live stream on YouTube. Professor Dr. Kuruvilla Joseph, Outstanding Professor and Dean of Indian Institute of Space Science and Technology, Trivandrum, was the chief speaker for the day. Induction programs were also held by various departments for their respective students. The Department of Physics conducted a two-day induction program via Google Meet. Dr. P.R. Biju, Associate Professor at School of Pure and Applied Physics, Mahatma Gandhi University, Kottayam, and Dr. Santosh Potheri Kuruvilla, Associate Professor and Head of the Department for Physics, BPC College, Piravam, were the resource persons for the event. The Department of Malayalam held their induction program for the PG students under the title Preface to Higher Education. The session was led by Dr. K. Radhakrishna Varier, former Director of the Department of Printing and Publishing, Mahatma Gandhi University. The induction program for the UG and PG students of the Department of History was led by Vidya Parvati, acclaimed corporate trainer. Online admissions for MA Economics begin. The online application for the newly started post-graduation in economics in the aided stream commenced on 9th December. Aspiring candidates should submit their applications on or before 21st December. 20 seats have been sanctioned for the course. Further details are available on the college website. New manager for CMS College. Right Reverend Dr. Uman George was appointed as the new moderator commissary for the CSI Madhya Kerala Mahidavaga. He will also serve as a new manager for the CMS College. He was appointed as a replacement for the retiring bishop and manager, Right Reverend Thomas K. Uman. He also serves as a bishop for the Kollam Kuttarakara Diocese. He will serve in his position until the election of the new bishop for the CSI Madhya Kerala Mahidavaga. The non-teaching staff of the CMS College organized a felicitation function in honor of Right Reverend Thomas K. Uman. Vidya Tarangam Phase 3 completed. The third stage of the Vidya Tarangam program undertaken by Vidya Sahradam, the Alumni Association for College, was conducted at the college office on 7th December. 25 smartphones were distributed to the needy students during this phase. The project has distributed around 70 smartphones to deserving students so far. The applications for the next phase will be invited soon. CMS students clear UGC NET and JRF examinations. This term's UGC NET JRF results for the humanities subjects have been announced. It is a matter of pride to know that over 18 of our students have qualified for the same. Lakshmimol CP, Shruti Prakash and Vaishna Jayagosh of the Department of English, Anjali Marin Joseph and Olivia Teresa A of the Department of Sociology qualified JRF. Priyanka PS, Krishna Priya Shashi and Devika Murlidharan of Commerce Department, Govind S, Ashley Josi, Matthews Kurian, Arundhati B, Gayatri Pratip and Samya Sara Abraham of the English Department, Tissi Koshi, Teresa Mary Sabu and Joji George of Sociology Department and Anatole Kitangachan of the Department of Malayalam qualified the NET examinations. Postponement of examinations. The undergraduate examinations scheduled on 4th December were postponed due to the threat of Cyclone Bureli. The revised dates will be announced later. Dialectos launched its second episode. The interview series titled Dialectos Conversation with Great Minds launched its second episode with a dialogue between Dr. Jopi J, medical officer at the Government Homeo Dispensary, Etumanur, and Professor Jacob Epen Kunnath, assistant professor of the Department of English. Dr. Jopi J has also been the project officer of the Communicable Diseases Control and Prevention Program and the convener of the Janani Fertility Project. The session discussed topics relating to homeopathy and its benefits during the COVID pandemic. CMS student receives the NN Kakar Literary Award. Adit Krishna, a first-year undergraduate student of the Malayalam department, received the 11th NN Kakar Award for his literary work, Kiduvendu Yatra. Mailpeeli Charitable Society organizes the NN Kakar Literary Award to recognize young, aspiring authors under the age of 18. The award comprises a cash prize of ₹10,001, a sculpture and a felicitation letter. CMS student releases her debut novel. Literary talents are not rare in the Department of Malayalam. Alina Kuriakos, first-year BA Malayalam student, released her first novel titled Agneya on Thursday, November 26. Reverend Father Dr. Paul V. Madden released her maiden work. The first copy was received by Father Anil Kiliyilikudi and Father Paul Parekattil. The novel comes out with a strong message against corruption, arrogance and exploitation. This simple and elegant style of its rendering makes the work accessible to all readers. Agneya also seeks to inspire social transformation in our society. Bibliophile Online Book Review Contest. The college is organizing a book review contest for its students. Students are expected to write a book review on any book that they have read during the COVID-19 period. The review must not exceed 10 pages and can be submitted in English or Malayalam before 15th January. Three prizes will be awarded to the three best reviews. Further details are available on the college website. NSS NCC volunteers selected. The college selected first-year undergraduate volunteers for the 2020-21 academic year of the NSS unit. About 100 volunteers were selected from 17 departments. NCC cadets were also selected from the first-year undergraduate students. The selection process was held under the leadership of Ditto Prasad, Associate Officer and Military Officers in charge of the 16th Kerala Battalion. More than 60 students participated in the program. Herbal Garden at Home project launched. The NSS unit of the college initiated the project Herbal Garden at Home. K.S. Sabukutan, the NSS State Program Officer, inaugurated the project. The representatives have set up about 250 herbal gardens in 14 districts of Kerala. Every vote matters. Even under the shadow of the COVID pandemic, the elections to the local bodies were held in three phases throughout the state. Teachers and non-teaching staff from CMS have been very much part of the efforts. The election saw newer methods to gather the votes of the COVID patients. The polling officers were assigned to collect votes from the COVID patients quarantined at their homes. The journey of these officers in PPE kits had gained much media attention. Now that the election process has been successfully completed, we have to await the results. That's all for today. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for our next bulletin. This is Mona Harish signing off.